All praises to the Most High Yahweh, the Heavenly Father, in the name of the Holy Spirit, the Earthly Mother, sanctifying Yahusha, the Holy Son. Brothers and sisters, Jews and Gentiles alike, welcome. This is your humble servant, Big Levi, and today is Tuesday, August the 3rd, 2021, and it's currently 11:53 p.m. Peace be with you. May peace be unto you, brothers and sisters. There'll be no Jacob's trouble. What you're experiencing here, what you're seeing here, it's called Esau's trouble and the Gentiles' tribulation. And also the two-thirds punishment. You are going to see, you are going to witness a fair amount of videos that the Heavenly Father is visiting this earth. There is a holy visitation in the midst of this earth, and there are a lot of people that are being touched, paid, and punished for what they did to the children of the Lord. Now, beloved brothers and sisters, just be forewarned, this video is going to be at least 2 hours. So we are going to go ahead, we're going to take all kind of videos, we are going to look at them, what's happening right now and what's happening in the present. Just to let the nation know to forgive me, yesterday I did not have the time to release another video, and family and all that, plus I didn't sleep last night at all. I woke up, I didn't sleep at all, and then when I was getting a little sleep, and you know, the demon upstairs were like thumping, I couldn't sleep at all. So beloved, let us go, let us watch the videos and see if the Father's truly doing this, or is it being done by men? Let us keep on moving. This is a tornado hits Andropol, Tver, Russia, August 2nd, 2021, which was yesterday, which is, you know, today's the 3rd, and 5 more minutes, it will be the 4th. All right. You see the tornado behind the house? All right, this is plague number 10, though. Anything that have to do with the weather, there are plagues that is embedded in number 10, thunder voices, and the 10 plagues of the apocalypse of Abraham. All right, see this giant tornado right here, and those people, they are probably there's music in there, and then it's being muted. All right, so this thing is all over the earth. All right, this is the damage. Oh, this is the damage. All right, that's the damage. So now you see, yesterday you saw a tornado, and a couple of days ago you saw a tornado in Pennsylvania and New Jersey, and then now this is Russia. August the 2nd. The Father is not playing, beloved. Give the Father praises and glory. Those people come. Look at this. Look at this. All their houses are gone. Again, beloved, this is not stage. This is not a CGI. This is not something those people stage to get money from FEMA or whatever. This is real. This is being done by the Heavenly Father himself. This has nothing to do with conspiracy. This is real. This is in real time. Those people are suffering. The Most High is sweeping them off the land, literally. All right? Look at this. All right? This is the aftermath. Okay, all the houses are gone, brothers. They are gone. All right? Okay? So this is the technology. Chainsaw. Okay? That's the technology. A little cell phone filming. They don't have any of those satellites they claim they have in the sky. They can stop any tornado, or they can control tornadoes for that matter. Okay, so this is all destroyed. I believe that's what that means. Okay, you hear the chainsaw? That's the technology. Is that thing even recording right now? Yes, it is.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
All right, that's the technology. This is the damage. The houses are being flattened, the trees. All right, look at this. Trees and the cabodial and all that. All right, so those people do not have the technology to do these things to themselves. They cannot control the weather point blank period. Only the Most High can do this, and he did this to them. Okay, so let us read the comment if there is, you know, a little. Okay, the damage corresponds to the classy EF3 tornado heading towards camera guy. Russian dude's gonna keep recording this. Okay, I wonder if tornadoes are common enough in Europe that they have a tornado season like we do here in the States. Anyone know where I could find, you know, let's see. I'm wondering that too. This article says study that is down to months area and time frame give them. We don't have tornado season. We have had sky pumps. The weather in Europe is going nuts. I live in Denmark. We have had heat wave. Germany's country to your borders, they got massive flash floods while we have heat wave. It only takes 2 hours to drive from Denmark to Germany. The weather in Europe is changing and fast. All praises to the Most High, Yahweh. All praises. This is coming from Heidi Ricciardi. Okay? So, he said that the weather is changing very fast in Europe. So, you mean to tell me the European, the one that controlling the world, that's what you guys always said, they are changing the weather to where they stay at. They are destroying their own land. They are sending heat wave to the Denmark's, to Denmark, to Germany. They are sending a flood. But I thought that's where they live at. I saw most of them, isn't most white folks leaving Europe? Why they're destroying Europe? If they are being swept off Europe, that means Europe is not their land. It's not coming over there. Okay? Okay, yes, even in Sudan, in Africa, there is tornado season, or that Russians say hurricane, there have been every continent except Antarctica. All right, let me see. See, these storms are getting intense. Beloved, those people, they are noticing too. They simply don't want to give the credit to the Most High. They keep saying Mother Nature. And I know, my friend, her mother's name is Nature, and she's not doing this. You know who's doing this? The Most High, Yahweh. Yes. Mrs. Nature, she can do this. She's a human, just like me. Yeah, that's true. You know, my homeboy, mother, her mother name, last name, middle name is Nature, and she's not doing this. The Most High, he's doing that. The God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob is doing this. All right, beloved? Is that thing even recording right now? All right, let us keep on moving. Okay. All right, this is Russia again. That's another tempest. Well, I believe that's a urgent, a forceful tempest or hurricane causes destruction and Asustado. This is kind of like, I think this is, this is Portuguese, but anyway. That thing got songs in it. Okay, look at this. This is like this, enlarge this. Have you ever heard of the expression, the snake eating its tail? This look like a snake biting its tail. Okay, this is the eyes of the snake, you know, the head, and then this is the snake tail, you know, biting its tail right here. It's like the snake wrapping on the earth, and then this is where the head meets and bites its tail right there. You know, let me see if I can see what I'm to better illustrate it, what I'm saying. snake eating its tail symbol?
According to City of Grove, the Ouroboros is an ancient symbol depicting a serpent or dragon eating its own tail. Okay. The name originates from within Greek language, meaning tail, and meaning eating, thus, he who eats the tail.
He who eats the tail. The Ouroboros. Okay. That's what it looks like to me. Alright. I think it means a cycle or something that is ever ended. Yeah, it looks like this. It looks like a dragon eating another dragon tail. Two dragon holding the whole thing. That's how it looks like from this side when I'm looking at it. Could be crazy things. You know, lately we've been seeing a lot of dragons and stuff. Okay, snake eating his tail. Okay. There you go. All right. See the snake right here and then the tail. Let us keep on going. All right. It's wrapping around the sky. Okay. So all of these things, beloved, they are real. All right. Okay, the sky is all dark. This is still in Russia. All right. Let me see if there's a... Okay, they are inside of a warehouse. All right, beloved. Watch this. They let the door open. All right. That's the storm. You see? This is outside, beloved. You see that the lightning, the tempest, the flooding, everything. They are inside of, a hangar, an airplane hangar.
Holy crap, it's
okay? Look at this. All right? The Most High is not playing, man. Men do not have the power to do this. Men cannot do this. Men do not have any type of instrument to do that. All right? This is frightening those people, man. It's quite frightening. You see the lightning in the midst of all of that. Okay? So you can see all sort of things moving in the sky. The Most High is angry. He's telling them he's visiting. Look at the tornado forming here. Look at Rahaviel dancing in the mist over there. All right? Look at this. Ripping off roof. All right? All praises to the Most High. Look at this. Look at this. Taking everything away. We give praises and glory to the Most High. Mostly they are in Portuguese. Yeah. All right. Well, I can't read Portuguese and I'm not going to... translated. Anyway, let us move. Alright. So, again, this is strong winds batter China, ripping off records and roofs. This is August 3rd, 2021, which was yesterday for them. Or well, yesterday. Today is just the 4th. So, see? Look at this. The people are on their knee. Look at this. Like, damn. Look at this, brethren. Woo. It's daylight. Look at this. It's daylight. Day turn into night. Look at the lightning. You can see all sort of faces over there. Let's play it on slow motion for the nation to see. The Most High is not playing. China is under judgment, okay? We're playing this in slow motion. Okay, we're going to mute this. All right, so the people, look at this. Look at the lightning. And night, and then it's day. Look at this. Flash of lightnings turn the day quickly into night. All praises to the Most High, man. All praises. The Heavenly Father is in the midst. Then again, beloved, this is plague number 10. Thunder, voices, okay? And destroying earthquake, the thunder. Look at this is beautiful, man. I can't get enough of that. Oops, let's put it at normal speed. Normal. Look at the lightning. Turn the day into night. Look at this. The trees are falling. A building roof is flying. This is the wrath of the Most High. The Chinese does not have a weapon to do this to themselves. The motorcycle fell. Okay? Look at the roof. Houses, power lines were seriously damaged. All right? Those people don't have time for this. They don't have time to mess with their own blessing. You know, electricity supply was cut for more than 10 hours in several towns. All right? Wind specially broke local records. Oh, local records. Like, is that like music records? Look at the tree falling. Okay? Look at this. Look at this. Oh! And then you see the lightning in the midst of all that flash flood. Look at Brethren. You see? Oh, man. Lightning. This is... Hang on. Lightning forked. And let's read this thing again. Wow. All right. So, look at this. Flash floods followed the heaviest rainfall on record in July. Look at this. Day turned into night, night turned into day. Lightning fork in the sky as rescuer battle floods at a dam. You cannot tell me this is not the Most High. You cannot tell me this is not the hand of our Father. Is that thing even recording right now? Yes, it is. Okay, the Most High is angry, man. Look at this. Look at this. Raging guts broke the glass windows of residence flat. Those people cannot have any peace. Can you imagine sit there watching TV? The trees are falling. Things are crashing cars. Look at the sheer forces. 98 miles. And now you can hear a woman screaming. Is that Raviel? Can hear it if it wasn't for that damn music. Those are the soul ripping out of there, man. Yeah. Oh, of course, fortunately, no casualty. Of course, I've been reported. You guys are not reporting anything. Okay, look at this. This is your technology using hand in hand. You do not have any of those super cool things that you're showing in your movies. China is getting it. Let's read a little bit of the comment. The pace of which the climate change is happening is absolutely horrifying, given the fact that this is only the beginning of the beginning. It is like the weather is going crazy everywhere. The weather is so weird over here too. We've never had a summer like this. And there are weird, untypical anomalies almost weekly. It is not like there's one event every now and then. Afterward, it's all normal again for at least some time. It's weird all the time, okay? Those people, to them, they think it is some type of anomalies. It is the weather, okay? And this guy, you know. The main thing is that there isn't any casualty or survival. That's not true. That's not true. We got 45 reply, okay? So to those people, beloved, they think it's climate change. They think it's the elite. They think China has some type of weapon. You know, they didn't try it in Africa. They are invading Africa. They don't try it over there. Okay, they don't try it here in the U.S. since they want to take over so bad. Okay, they are using it on their own people. They are flooding their own people and kill their own people and disturb their own peace and disturb their own blessing. They think that's what that is. And they think that even worse, it's climate change or Mother Nature. We want to tell you this is the Heavenly Father. He is doing this. Why? Because of Genesis 15, verse 13. Genesis 15, verse 13 said, and he said unto Abram, know of a surety that thy seed shall be a stranger in a land that is not theirs, and shall serve them, and they shall afflict them 400 years. We, what you are calling black folks, black Americans, the so-called Caribbeans, we fulfill this prophecy our people, our ancestors, we were enslaved and still are enslaved in our own land. We fulfilled this prophecy from 1619 to 2019. And since 2020 kicks in, the Father locked up the entire world and is boxing you in. As now, we are witnessing Genesis 15, verse 14. And also, that nation whom they shall serve will I judge. And Father's judging you through the 10 plagues of the apocalypse of Abraham. And this is plague number 10. Okay? That's what that is. Let us see some of the reply. Which country you are from? Okay, that guy name is Carl Sagan. In America, they are always anomalous. Okay, it's because of us human that this kind of thing are happening. No, we can't blame anyone but ourselves. They always get hit by some kind of typhoon or cyclone or storm. It happens in many countries, not as often as America. Here at the Philippines, we got strange and horrifying climate change disasters, from hot summer reaching 50 degrees Celsius and typhoons, 2-3 low pressure areas, strong typhoons such as Sepaka, Fabian, and more. Okay, Delta, nothing. This is a Chinese game. The way we have captured the world by doing, always put the, this is Chinese doing this. Yeah, whatever, man. This is really sad and terrifying. It's like a horror movie scene when spaceship landed on Earth. You have no idea. Yo, Simrat Prit Kahu, you have no idea. When spaceship lands on Earth, you do not have the slightest idea away. All right. All right. Yes. And Mother Nature is a force to be reckoned with. Love it, respect it. No, the Most High is a force to be reckoned with. Love him and respect him. And you will know his name. You will know his name. All praises. Let us move. Is that thing even recording? All right. Let us move in, brethren. Okay. This is in China again. Okay. Okay. Ley line. This is in China. There's a woman in the passenger seat. You know, instead of everybody get the hell out, they stay in the car. They don't want the car to go. Okay. All right. This woman bail out. This dude bail out. That other woman stay. The guy in the phone could have just pressed the thing, but he bailed out. He like, I'm out. That guy got out. And then the car fell. Alright. She had the a multiple waist injury. All praises to the Most High. This is in Texas, all right? Okay, huge, all right? This is right here in Texas, okay? Crazy storm is destroying Texas. Huge hail smashes cars and roofs, which is plague number 6. Increase of hail and snow, all right? All right, you see the hails? All right. People love filming portrait. Alright. Look at this. Look at this. This isn't normal, man. This is in Texas. And the thing is, beloved, it's not like something they see coming. They don't see that coming. It's, they don't have the technology to see this thing coming. They cannot warn the people in time. All right, see the hailstorm or dropping in the pool. Plague number 6. This is no joke. This thing is real. This hish is real. And if you get hit with those things, it can kill you. The trajectory, the projectile can kill you. Yeah. Look at this, beloved. All right. Those are hells. Okay. Plague number 6. Increase of hell. It's only going to increase, beloved. It's only going to increase. All right. Let us move to the next video. All praises to the Most High. Burning tree split in half after lightning strikes near Big Bear. Okay. Is that North Dakota? Huh. No, that's not North Dakota. That's somewhere. There's a place in North Dakota called Big Bear, I believe. Bear Butte. Yeah, Bear Butte. Is that what that is? Let me check. Bear Butte, North Dakota. No. No, 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 no. Ah, all right. All right. That's a massive ley line. But anyway, I don't know why I say Bear Butte. But anyway, so. All right. See? This is. You see what you watch this. This is the barrier. Watch this. That's the tree splitting out her hands and give the Most High praises and glory. Okay, watch this. All praises, man. All praises to the Most High.
And then the fire. A 200-year-old Jeffrey pine tree in Big Bear, no longer standing. A lightning bolt struck it, setting it on fire and eventually splitting it into pieces. That tree stood right across the street from the Big Bear Airport. Michael Bogan captured this video and says a series of photos saying the healthy tree had an unlucky day. Firefighters also responded to another lightning fire in the same area.
Hello, I'm Mark Brown.
All praises to the Most High. Big Bear, the Holy Spirit, okay? This is all symbolic, all right? What you're seeing here is the barrier. I believe there's a picture that we had that was a fire in Colorado. Let me see if I can get this, all right? Okay, this was a fire burning in Colorado. It was snowing, and then this appeared. They captured it. That was the barrier, all right? Huh, I don't know why I can't zoom into this thing. Huh. Why I can't zoom in? Hang on. Is that thing recording? Yes. Yeah, apparently I cannot zoom in this. Don't know why. Okay, so that's a debarrier standing right here, just like you see this. All right? You see the difference? All right. Okay. All right. So, those are very symbolic things. I made a video about this in September. It's going to be a year now. Okay, all praises to the Most High, man. All praises. All right, let us keep on moving. Let's see if anybody say anything interesting. Trees don't frighten me. Box worse than die bite. Big Bear has the biggest spine. See, they don't know. They don't have the spirit. Oh, okay. Beloved sister is here, Mama Wark. Okay. All right. All praises to the Most High. Be at peace, family. On the behalf of the covenant, Genesis 15, 13, and 4, still stand. You know, it is said there'll be no Jacob's trouble. That's what that is, sister. Okay, the sister is here. She let it know. Oh, yeah, yeah. Those are scumbag. Lightning or D-E-W. Yeah. All right, wow, God is angry. Good, 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 good. Mm-hmm. Okay, funny how camera was there to capture the moment a DEW being used. Yeah, always some goddamn conspiracy theories. Sadly, we had to see your comment on here to show that DEW fry your brain. All praises. God trying to tell you something. Are you listening? Yes. Are you listening? This can only be done by the Heavenly Father, okay? If you enlarge this, you know, you can see all sort of things here. It seems like this is a woman. The smoke look like a woman. Like this is her face's nose facing that way. And this is her chest. And then she's wearing a dress, a long dress. And this is her hair back, and this is her hair, okay, all the way on the back, and this is her back, okay, again, that's what that looks to me. All right. And then if you look right here, this look like a skull. Eyes, nose, and mouth of the skull, and then the head of a skull. Crazy thing. All sort of crazy things. All right. So that's the Heavenly Father doing this. All praises to the Most High. Good. Okay. Wait a minute. Who is this guy? Sometime those guys will strike you. Let me see. Okay, sometime they will strike you. Okay, so this guy won't strike. It won't strike. All right, then. So that's Utah, okay? Flash Flood and Judah, Yehuda. All right, Flash Flood and Judah. Look at this. All praises to the Most High. Damn! The Most High. Woo! The Most High is not giving those people no peace at all, no rest. He's tormenting them. Look at this. Okay, those people are stuck in the road like this. Is that a Jeep? I believe, yeah, it's a Jeep. All right, nice, nice, nice Jeep. But stay where you at, man. Don't try to be a hero out there. See? The flood washes those cars away. And those things has people in them. All right? There are people in there. There are people in there. That's hailstorm. The hailstorm is dropping. The stones are dropping. Okay, this is plague number 6 right here. Increase of hail and snow, and aka number 10 too. Is that thing even recording right now? Yes, it is. All right, let us keep on going. All right, look at this. This is insane. Look at what she said. This is insane. We want to take like 3 minutes out of this. This is insane. Yes, it is. All right, the Mosa is destroying those people's stuff. Look at this. The back of this car is all broken. Okay, this is not a little thing, beloved. This is not a little thing. All right. Ooh, and they are driving in this thing.
There's a bridge at Sugar House Park and the road.
Look at this. I believe they were praying in Utah for rain, and then now they are praying for the rain to stop because, you know, this thing is too much.
Wow.
All right. Damaging the houses, the library. All right. The Mosa is tormenting them. They cannot have peace. They will not have peace. All praises to the Most High, man. Okay. All right. No peace for the wicked. All praises.
As the crisis deepens at hospitals and hotspots, tonight the numbers are staggering and sobering. Surpassing last summer's average for new cases, our nation has again recorded over 100,000 infections in a single day. The Delta variant filling ICUs and killing more Americans from week to week.
If you get sick with the Delta variant, we estimate that you could infect about 5 other unvaccinated people, more than twice as many as the original strain.
Again, beloved, we have no comment. We're just going to see and witness USC's 100,000 new cases in one single day. And just one day, they saw 100,000 new cases. So we showed you, we haven't checked this thing yet because they keep messing with stuff. You can't see anything, you know, okay? When you check the map, you know, they showed you, like, when you check the overview, everything is fine. You know, in fact, let me see, UK report highest number of deaths since mid-March, amid 20,000, okay, you know, 5 hours ago. Israel ranks second globally in coronavirus innovation. Mm-hmm. Which country have administered the fewest 19 jab? So, yeah, you know, so they're showing you that, you know, since July the 30th, like, you know, everything is good. you know, let me see, last May, they are talking about May 2021, okay, last August, see, summer, last August, when they had like 200 and stuff like that, you know, and then now, they have like 600,000, you know, 700,000, 500,000. It's even worse than it is now than it was in 2020. And really, they are, they don't really want to say things, you know. They keep focusing on Haiti now, you know, try to spread that plague over there. They've been trying spreading that thing for a while. It's just, it's not spreading the way that they want it. Okay, 200,000 cases, for over 4 million deaths. It was at 3 million, brethren. Remember when that time it was at 3 million? Now it's over 4.2 million deaths. Okay, the U.S. Just hit 36 million. I believe the beloved sister Lisa Cabrera made a video. They hit 35. Not even a few weeks ago. Now they are 36 million. India is right behind. You know? Brazil is here. Russia is there. France is here. The UK is over there. Turkey. You know, let us see. What they gonna do with where is Haiti right there? So Haiti got 560 deaths. Last time we checked, it was 337 deaths. So they got over 20,000 cases. Okay, all right. So that's what that is, man. So for 2 years they have 560 deaths. So. Yeah, they try to spread that thing over there, try to bring the vaccine because they're like, oh, you people really need this and stuff. And nah, you dealing with this.
Though it comes nearly a month after the president's 4th of July goal, today 70% of adults are at least partially vaccinated.
So they reached the goal of 70, that magic number, 70, the 70 shepherd. Okay, the 70 elders. All right, then.
But every day, more breakthrough infections are being reported.
So, you know what breakthrough is, brothers? Breakthrough is like the one that had the cure, and then for some odd reason, yeah.
Senator Lindsey Graham, now in quarantine after announcing his infection, says being fully vaccinated kept his COVID symptoms from being far worse.
Even with a high vaccine effectiveness, most of these infections are going to be asymptomatic or mild.
With daily infections predicted to double by fall, some hospitals are already seeing a surge worse than before.
A federal disaster team is arriving in Louisiana, where ICU beds are short on supply and a new face mask mandate indoors is back in place. Lines for testing stretching for hours today in Florida, after the state just set its pandemic record for new cases and patients hospitalized.
They're asking for the vaccine now. They're like, just give it to me. We want to get it. Mm-hmm. Which now they have to wait, unfortunately, until they get better and get out of the hospital.
Hoping to boost inoculations in New Jersey, the governor says healthcare workers like those at nursing homes must be vaccinated or face weekly testing. New York's governor encouraging businesses to require proof of vaccination from patrons, but stops short of mandating masks indoors. Tonight, the push to inoculate and to save lives. As hospitals lose more Americans every day.
Miguel, is these infections.
So, yeah, that's what happened. We have no comment on that. We're just going to keep it moving.
Overworked and in short supply. As Stephen Fabian reports, they're concerned now about their ability to do their jobs.
An ICU nurse breaks down over the latest COVID surge.
The Delta wave that we're seeing now. People are younger and sicker.
Felicia Croft says among the patients at her hospital in Shreveport, Louisiana, are the parents of her 14-year-old daughter's friend.
Her friend's parents are in my ICU, and one of them may not go home. The other one's really, really sick too. And as a nurse, to know that if you can't get these two people home, that they're...
Come on, promote that thing, man. We know you're here to promote this thing. Go ahead, promote it.
Kids will be orphans.
Nurse Felicia's heartbreaking video is going viral today.
What's going on in your Louisiana hospital right now?
Okay, do you know all those guys, the way they make this thing is all fake? They act like they are talking to this person through this camera, right? It's all fake. They don't talk to them, like, they just pre-record that. You know, the scumbag are making sure they make it look like, oh, this is live and stuff. That's not what that is.
Our numbers are up. They are way, way up from where we were, you know, just a few weeks ago. In the beginning, it was more the older population. But with this wave that we've seen, it has been just a totally different story. Everybody is susceptible at this point.
Lindsay Fairchild is also an ICU nurse from Daytona Beach, Florida, who finds the current surge overwhelming. Because of COVID protocols, she had to watch through a window as her own father slipped away last year.
Okay, so this is no joke, man. This is no joke. So the people, what they are saying, listen, beloved. Now, one thing they are not telling you, all those people, the parents of this 14-year-old girl, this fellow, the parents of this nurse, all of those people once did live in this land, okay? All of those people, once they had jobs, okay? Let's say if this guy was a pilot, he used to quote-unquote flying planes. Okay, so he's no longer here. So who's going to replace it? You simply cannot just grab somebody walking down the street and say, hey, you can drive a car? Yeah, well, then drive this plane. It doesn't work like that. Those people that are dying, brothers, they had jobs too. They had lives too. Now, when you see the economy cannot grow, you cannot say, oh, everybody's like being lazy and unemployment and home and stuff like that. No, those people are no longer here. If this man did own a house, well, most likely the house is going to stay for the daughter. But a lot of those people, the whole family died. Who's going to own their stuff? The government? The government is already being disbanded. They're just putting a show right now. So, yeah, you know, I don't know what that is, but you may not be able to see it, but this look, it seems like this is like a deaf angel right here. It's like this, there's this face right here with the hair going right here. And then it seems like she holding like a hammer, like some type of weapon, and then floating over him. Okay. That's what it looks like to me. You know, crazy things. We're saying crazy things. Okay, she. You see how those two tube are going onto her. It's like she's pulling, sucking the soul out of him. All praises to the Most High, man. All right, this thing is real. All right, this is real.
Flipped away last year.
It's as bad as it could possibly be. It's actually worse now than it ever was last year.
Here in New York City, a major development today in the fight against the pandemic. Mayor Bill de Blasio announced that the city will be phasing in a policy that will require proof of vaccination for staff and customers of indoor dining, gyms, and indoor entertainment.
If you want to participate in our society fully, you got to get vaccinated.
Okay, those guys made it clear. They made it clear unto you. If you want to participate in their society, you have to get their cure. Do you want to be a part of her? When the Heavenly Father say, come out of her, my people, so you may not partake in her sin and their sin. You see, what those people, all their businesses, they have ley lines, they have things in there, you know, they draw energy from people, from massive amount of people. Okay, they lost too many people 2020, and then they are not doing too well, especially the Olympic right now. That thing is a joke. There's nobody there. The whole thing is a joke. So this guy tells you straight up, if you want to enjoy our hash, man, you know, you gotta take our stuff. Ain't gonna come in over there and be in our society and try. Although they already have 70% of the population, you know, getting this thing. You should have reached herd immunity. That's what you people say, but somehow it's not working. You know, straight from the horse's mouth. Let us listen to it again.
And indoor entertainment.
If you want to participate in our society fully, you got to get vaccinated. You gotta get vaccinated. It's time.
In hard-hit Miami and Fort Lauderdale, the lines of people waiting to get tested were enormous. Yet another sign that the pandemic is far from over.
That's the thing. This is the, it's amazing how you people were so proud and say, oh, we've vanquished this thing. This thing is working. It's working. And we got like 60% of this. Throw the mask away. Open everything. The churches and stuff. And everybody that used to be here go straight back to church. And most of those people are not coming back. You see, right now it's better than ever. Those people are dying quietly. They are dying while the entire earth is talking about, I don't know, the Olympic, the game, the football, the soccer game, okay? And a lot of people are dying quietly. The Father is sweeping them off the land. Beloved, keep on praying, holding the line, fast, pray, repent, repeat. While we are at it, this Thursday coming up, that's going to be the 5th of August, we are calling a holy fast. To send back to the sender everything, all the spells, all the witchcraft, all the curses, all the plagues that we have on us. We're going to pray the Heavenly Father in the 10th hour and fast and send it back to whoever sent it. Whether it was a personal curse or what a personal spell somebody put on you, you may know or may not know. Send it back to the sender and quarantine it and them for eternity. All praises to the Most High. Let us move to the next video.
We don't like to begin with or report at all a surge in virus cases, yet here we are talking about the third wave already. Has it arrived in India? The short answer is yes, it's almost here. Experts say the third wave begins this month. Numbers say it's in the making. For 7 straight days, India has reported a spike in cases, a steady increase.
Okay, so this is August the 2nd, yesterday, or what, 2 days ago. Okay, so India third wave is there. And you know what happened in May, man. For those of you who don't know, you saw what happened in May in India. Listen, this is how the Father does it. I'll say this again, once more. Let me see if that thing is even recorded. This is how the Heavenly Father do it. Those people were living in the blessing under, that's a metaphor, under the earth in a cave. They never seen light. They were living in darkness. Some way, somehow, the Father brought them to the surface. The Father brought them at night to the surface. And they did like the surface better than underground, better than the cave. They had no lights. They came in at night. They can actually see the stars. They love it. But the sun rises. The sun started to rise. They said this is a big, bright, there's a fire coming out the sky. And it started, well, 9, 10, 11 p.m., this big, bright fire in the sky start burning their skin. And they are not used to this. And they don't know what it was. And then they started this thing and they said, oh, well, then by 4, 6 p.m., this thing should die. And 6, 7 p.m. and then the sun starts setting and then they start partying. They're like, yeah, it's going to be dark forever again. By 9 p.m., 10 p.m., the sun set and then they're like, this sun is never going to come back. And then they're partying again, 11 p.m. party, 12 a.m. party, 1 a.m. keep partying because they're like, yo, man, remember when that giant big fire come out of the sky and burning our skin and stuff? A lot of us die. Yeah, we remember that. And then right now it's 9 a.m. The sun is back in the sky again. And then now they start to realize that it's going to be an everyday thing. It's going to be an everyday thing. Until they can't go back to the cave. They can't go back underground. They're going to stay above ground and all of them going to die. Because they are not used to things like this. That's what's going to happen here. When those people think this thing is gone, they're like, yo, party, party. India was the first who came and say, we Indian defeated this. All the world supposed to take example following us. And then boom, May happen. And then after May, June entered, they're like, oh, we defeat this damn and stuff. And July, they're like, okay, we good. This thing is gone. Open up everything. Boom. August happened. China is the same thing. They are not used to this thing, brothers. Those people used to resolve, well, they not them. They, quote unquote, used to resolve problem in a snap. They used to have us resolve the problem in a snap with prayers. Now we no longer pray for them. We pray against them. Now they are seeing that this thing, even though it's gone, for these few months, it's going to get back stronger with a new variant and it's going to kill more people until all of you are gone. And it's not something that's going to take 10 years, 5 years, 6 years. It's not. You got till 2024. All right, then.
And India is not alone in reporting this trend. Countries around the world are fighting a new wave of infections. In the last 2 weeks, the United States has recorded a whopping 148% spike in new cases. In China, the Delta variant is driving a new surge. As many as 27 cities are reporting.
How many city, brothers and sisters? You know what to do. 27 cities in China. You know what to do?
An outbreak. The Chinese press is calling this the worst outbreak since Wuhan. Australia, too, is reporting a major surge. The lockdown is being extended in Brisbane. And in Sydney, the military has been deployed to enforce stay-at-home orders. That's how serious it is.
Because
do you notice a trend here?
It is. Because what's happening, beloved brothers and sisters, those people do not want to let it go. You see, the best way for them to lift this curse is to come clean to the people and say, listen, the reason why this is happening, the reason why this is going on, it is because we did enslave the children of the Lord. We make them work in slavery, and they are not named as blacks. They are the sons and daughters of the living power. And we must pay for what we did. Let us step up. And then the Most High would have mercy on them. Nope. They figured out if they put the military out there upon their own people, forcing their own people to stay home so they can curb this thing. And the Gentiles is not about that, man. They're all about that blessing. They're all about that partying and enjoy it. Okay? So it's really hard for them to stay home. Okay? A lot of suicide, a lot of those things.
Yeah. The United States, China, Australia, these are countries that said that they had tamed the Wuhan virus.
Exactly. Those were the people that boasted like, yo, we won because the sun went down. They never seen the sun before. They met the children of the sun. We told them, what are you talking about? This is the sun. It's going to do this perpetually. Did I say that right? Let's define the word perpetually. It's supposed to be forever. Define perpetually.
Here's the definition of perpetually: in a way that never ends or changes, constantly.
Yeah, perpetually.
Perpetually.
It's a perpetual thing. It's going to stay forever. It's not going to end. Today, he killed 4 million of you. Tomorrow, 12 million. The next day that comes after tomorrow, 50 million. The following day, 200 million. The following that, 3 billion. And after, you guys are gone. It's only going to multiply and it's not going to stop. And some 83 were the people that say, hey, we won, open up everything, the churches and everything. Oh, okay, all right, whatever. Go ahead then.
So what explains these numbers then? A worldwide surge, daily global infections that have shot up to 540,000 new cases every day. Almost 70,000 deaths every week. It's been 20 months since the first outbreak in Wuhan, and we still haven't been able to defeat this virus. Does that mean we'll have to learn to live with it?
You cannot. It's impossible for you people to live with this. Because you know why? You're not a child of the sun. You cannot live in the sun. You were supposed to live underground in a cave and stay there. You cannot live with this thing killing millions of you out there, and then you guys are hiding the numbers, and then you're acting like you defeat this thing. We told you there is no way you cannot defeat the Most High. You come up with all kind of conspiracy theories to make yourself feel good. I don't hear Bill Gates here anymore. Where is Bill Gates? I don't hear the elites anymore. Now you guys are truly concerned. You guys are truly concerned now. You bring all sort of scumbag, backwitted, buck-toothed hillbilly on the internet, tell people this is men causing this, men are doing this, so they can sell the vaccine. Now they are giving this shit for free. They are giving it for free now. They are offering, hey man, you want that? So put your shit for free. No, you cannot.
We'll discuss that and more tonight. First, let's talk about the situation in India. It's Monday, August the 2nd. India has reported more than 40,000 new cases in a day, and this is not a sudden rise. The number has been rising for almost a week now. In the last 6 days, India has breached the 40,000 mark every day, 40,000 new cases every day. On Sunday, 17 states and union territories had reported a rise in cases. So there's definitely a jump in new infections and a sustained trend. Experts say this could be the beginning of the third wave. Two researchers from IIT Hyderabad and Kanpur have been studying the graph closely. These are the same people who had accurately predicted the peak of the deadly second wave. Now they have come up with a new model, and here is what it says. India may see another rise in new infections as soon as August, that is this month. How bad can it get?
Okay, let's see. Let's see, beloved. Let's see how bad can it get. Today's the 3rd and today's the 4th. We're going to keep praying, brothers. We're going to keep letting the Most High to give us our plume of protection, Psalm 91 verse 4, to take us under the feathers. Okay, under his feathers. We know the Most High is protecting us. To hell with everybody else. If your heart is covered and you still worshiping other God, you think this is a game, you think the elite is doing this so they can bring the mark of the beast, which is the vaccine, and then an RFID chip, Jacob Trouble, you still on this garbage? Hey, that's on you. All praises to the Most High.
The researchers have projected two possibilities, the best and the worst case scenario. The first projection is the best case scenario. It says that the third wave will peak with less than 100,000 new infections a day. 1 lakh new cases every day. That's the best case scenario. What about the worst case scenario? Going by this model, India could see nearly 150,000 new cases every day. So if this model is correct, India's third wave will not be as brutal as the second one. When will it end? If new infections pick up this month, they'll hit the peak in the month of October. Remember, these are just projections. And if there's one thing that we've learned this summer, it's this. We cannot take this virus lightly. If a third wave is on the horizon, it's best to be prepared. The focus should be on vaccination. A majority of the Indian population is yet to be vaccinated. Look at the numbers. Close to 27% of the population has got one dose. India has a huge population and a lot of people to cover. 27% have got one dose. Almost 8% are fully.
27%, man. Just like China, 27. You know what to do, man. You know what to do. All praises.
Vaccinated. The challenge is immense. So there is a risk of widespread infection. Now look at the United States. Almost 50% of the country is fully vaccinated, and yet the infections are rising.
And this is what it is with those people. They always bring the conflicted report. They say here it's 70%. They over there they say almost 50%. They have no idea what they are doing, brothers. You know, all we have to do is just stay here and then watch.
In the last month, new infections in the U.S. have grown by 4 times. In the past 2 weeks alone, new cases have risen by 148%. Hospitalizations have gone up by 73%. But vaccines make all the difference. Most of these patients are unvaccinated. About 97% of those who ended up in hospital had not taken even a single shot. Most American states are reporting a surge. One of the worst hit is Florida. It has broken last year's record in hospitalization. America's top disease expert, Anthony Fauci, is predicting difficult times ahead. He says there is, quote unquote, more pain and suffering ahead.
You have no idea. Woo, the Most High is grand, man. All praises to the Most High. Anyway, beloved, let's take another video, man. Those people have no idea, man. All right? This is China right here.
Changshu, you're leading with a headline, 38% at risk, 38% of GDP. Can you clarify what that number means?
So we add up the provinces with high risk and medium risk regions. So this time the outbreak, the what's worrying about this current outbreak is that it's not the biggest compared to the recent ones and the one at the beginning of the year, but it's the most widespread. So at this point, 18 provinces and municipalities have been affected. So that's the numbers we added up, the GDPs for the most affected.
Okay, much more garbage in there. So what they are seeing, brothers, and not only this thing is not stopping, it's not slowing down, it's spreading faster than ever. Okay, we give the Most High praises and glory. It's in China, it's not going to stop.
The latest one is a perceived partner of Beijing, a country that was on the fence until now. We're talking about Germany. They're sending a warship to the South China Sea, a frigate called Bayern. It has set off on a seven-month voyage. Around mid-December, it will cross the South China Sea. This isn't the first Western deployment here, but it could be the most consequential one. Let me tell you why. Reason number one, this deployment revives German interest in the South China Sea. Their last voyage through here was in 2002, nearly two decades back. Reason number two, Germany was considered non-committal on China. They wanted competition, not conflict, mostly because China is Germany's largest trading partner. So Berlin is putting a lot at stake with this voyage. Reason number three, Germany is linking up with regional allies. The frigate is not making a voyage for the sake.
All right, the Father's gathering them. Let them do their stuff. Stay out of it. Let the Heavenly Father handle business.
Forced a 70-year-old woman who is blurred.
All right. New York City, well, New York City, 70-year-old woman raped in the Bronx, the number 70, okay? All right, we're going to watch the old video and see what the Most High put in there for us.
New here at noon, the NYPD Special Victims Unit looking for the man who raped a woman at gunpoint in the Bronx.
Investigators say he was caught on surveillance video. CBS News' Natalie Dedrich live in Tremont with more. Natalie.
Yes, Chris and Mary, police tell us that that suspect followed a woman into her apartment building and was wearing some kind of Halloween or costume mask, which he later used to conceal his weapon. And we've been speaking to women here in the neighborhood who say they're nervous he's not caught yet.
Surveillance video shows a man reach into his pants and pull out a silver handgun. Police say he forced a 70-year-old woman who is blurred to conceal her identity into an apartment stairwell where he sexually assaulted and raped her at gunpoint. Neighbors who live nearby can't believe it.
Why would you do that? That's your mother. That's your grandmother.
It happened July 27th at around 2 a.m. in an apartment near Belmont Avenue and 180th Street. Police say the woman was hurt but didn't report the incident until yesterday when she went to the hospital for an evaluation.
To be in your own neighborhood and for someone to attack you like that, you know, that's very vicious. So that goes to show you there's something wrong with him. It's some kind of mental disorder.
Nah, that's not what that is. This guy has a demon on him. And don't be surprised that, well, that woman is 70 years old. The Most I already tell you something here. The 70 shepherd. Don't be surprised this woman is a church member. You know, don't be surprised this woman is one of those people that come upon the loin of the Most High. And then this happened to them. Okay, to her.
Even he needs help.
Bad. Very bad. And if as you catch somebody like that, I'll hold the person until the police come.
Surveillance shows the suspect leaving the building. The man is described as 5'8", weighing 170 pounds, last seen wearing a black do-rag, black hooded sweatshirt, and carrying a red costume mask.
Oh, Okay, so things like that happen, okay? All right, it could be the guy know him, some drug deal went wrong, something happened. So all we saying, brothers, we stay out of this. All praises to the Most High.
Railroad tracks in Superior Township. Neighbors are heartbroken for families whose lives are changed forever. Monday afternoon, two teenage girls died in a devastating car crash on Superior Road near First Street. A third is seriously injured at a hospital.
There's been crashes. I've seen plenty of crashes on this road, but to have a fatal like that's really sad.
A view from above shows the teen's vehicle flipped upside down and hit a tree. Washtenaw County Sheriff's deputies believe the girls were speeding when they crossed the railroad tracks and lost control. Ryan Caton lives nearby.
That's not what happened. All the railroads, they are ley line. They beat on top of ley line. So, you know, those girls were crossing and then the Most High switched the ley line and boom. They have to give you like the usual analysis, well, the usual suspect and the usual things because they don't know how did this happen. Like this dude say, hey man, I see a lot of Haitian around here, but this one,
I've witnessed people get air on these tracks. If they were going fast either direction, they could easily have gotten airborne and lost control that way. I've actually in the past seen cars lose control getting airborne.
Caton says the speed limit is 40, but it's not.
Yeah, speed limit 40, all praises. Yeah, magic number 40.
Uncommon to see cars flying down the road at 60 miles an hour.
I think it's a road where it's kind of between two major roads, so it's easy to get going fast and people just, they aren't paying attention and all of a sudden it's out of, you know, out of their control.
Deputies say before the crash, the teens hit another vehicle and took off. Deputies believe the driver started chasing them but didn't catch up. Now Caton has a message for others who speed down his street.
People just need to realize that speed kills, especially they didn't think they were going to be doing that today, so.
No, man, the ley line kills. You people been speeding on our land since 1492, from the horses to the cars. Zaza.
You got to slow down.
The road is back open as we speak. Now, earlier today, it was closed for more than 5 hours as deputies investigated. In Superior Township, Veronica Meadows, we'll send it back to you.
Victoria Saha has the details from Laughlin.
Metro Police and homicide detectives spend majority of their day inside the Aquarius Hotel trying to piece together what happened. Some of the guests I spoke with today say some parts of the hotel were blocked off to them. This is video a witness shared with us. You can see bystanders and what looks like security attend to someone on the floor after the fight. Police tell us the big fight broke out with up to 30 people early this morning inside the hotel. They say when they got there, there was a victim unresponsive. This person was taken to the hospital where he died. Some guests tell me they were told to avoid the McDonald's area and there are still cones and crime tape up this afternoon.
I guess he got beat up pretty bad, like by three or four, I don't know, it was like a whole bunch of people they said. So they jumped him pretty much and they threw a bar stool at the guy.
So yeah, a bar stool. Well, the earth is the Most High footstool. So what happened here, beloved brothers and sisters, you're seeing how the spirit is moving upon those people. They are doing crazy things and a lot of judgment is going on. You see a lot of people are fighting and beat people and they are dying. And the Most High always, and again, put something in there for us to see for how he is doing all those things. So what happened here, this dude was in a fight. And you are hearing this a lot more often, and then you're going to still hearing this in the future. People are getting killed with one punch. They just punch them, they fell on the floor, they hit their head, they die. They beat them, okay, they beat them so bad, with so much rage, with some intense hatred, they die. We were watching a video of another dude over here in Dania Beach. There was a party. He went over there and tell the guy to turn off the music. They beat him. He's in the hospital. He's in critical condition. We found another dude somewhere in Georgia. They used to hang out and drink and all of that. On Father's Day, they were having a party. He went and told the dude, hey man, can you put this thing down? He pulled up a shotgun, he put it in his belly, blew his belly out. We got another dude. He was dancing for no reason. A guy came out of the car and then punched him. He fell on the floor. You got another guy was standing in front of a business, a nightclub, and he got into an argument with somebody else. Walk up. He was arguing with a guy, and then a dude that he doesn't even know, none of them. He came and he punched the guy in the face. The guy fell on the floor, hit his head, and died. And then you got another one that happened in Applebee's. I believe the dude was working in Applebee's. Okay, he was taking orders, got into an argument with the customer. The customer punched him in the face, he died. And then you got this one. Okay, that's the Most High. That's the angels reporting back on America. All praises to the Most High.
Police have not said if they made any arrests. The witness also tells us he's...
Again, you know, the word Aquarius, you know, we are in the... Did we leave the age of Aquarius? What age are we on now? Age of Aquarius or...
Here is some information for Age of Aquarius for Aquarius. According to EarthSky, in the Book of World Horoscopes, Nicholas Campion suggests that approximated dates for entering the Age of Aquarius range from 1447 AD to 3597 AD. Campion also...
I'm not quite sure what age. I would have to ask the sister like Naima Laverne, but I don't know that this could symbolically say the Age of Aquarius is dead, or we just enter the Age of Aquarius. I'm not quite sure what that is. So, but all praises to the Most High.
Saw a couple of other people being helped out by paramedics, but police would not confirm that. Reporting from Laughlin.
Yeah, so wow, crazy things, man. All praises.
Kate Border from California is facing first-degree murder charges in the death of a suburban Chicago man.
36-year-old Terry Kennedy is being held without bond in DuPage County. WGN's Patrick Elwood live in Oak Brook Terrace with details on that. Patrick?
Micah and Ray, good evening to you. Kennedy remains behind bars at this hour after authorities say he beat another man. That beating eventually led to that man's death. That other man, also a skateboarder. Professional skateboarder Terry Kennedy is pictured here in a booking mugshot in DuPage.
So, this dude, back when I was in college, he used to be a skateboarder. He used to have his own TV show. And he used to be this fake guy out there. They were trying to make him into a rapper. That guy don't even know how to skateboarding. And then again, the Most High always put something in there. If you look in his throat right here, tell me what you see. Okay, if you see in this guy's throat, you always see the Most High always put things in there. So what happened is he killed another dude because of some girl. He beat the guy so bad that the guy died. So then again, you can see the demon in their faces, and you can see the mark of the beast on his neck. The crucifix, the cross in there. So this is the Most High telling you he is doing this, okay?
Kennedy is pictured here in a booking mugshot in DuPage County. He is facing a number of charges involving the murder of 23-year-old Josiah Casahunt. In a court document, it is alleged that he punched and kicked Casahunt at this Comfort Suites Hotel on Roosevelt Road in Oak Brook Terrace last Tuesday. After being hospitalized at Chicago's Rush Medical Center.
Then again, this dude, and you know, when you look at this ring that he wore is a crucifix, okay? And then this seems like this is a snake right here. We wear this ring, okay, which is a crucifix. And this young man, he got killed. He was the guy friend, and you know, the ring on the nose. This like, hey, why cowboys do this? Why would you do that? Why? What is it? Why? This is a cowboy thing. But anyway, so this dude, he killed a fellow because some woman, I don't know, something happened.
Center. He later died on Saturday. The medical examiner says he died of blunt force trauma. Online reports indicate the two men were friends. The 36-year-old Kennedy was originally charged last week with aggravated battery. Plus,
so this guy is 36 years old, okay? Then again, you know what to do. Okay, so this is all the Most High doing this, all right?
Criminal trespass to a woman's apartment in Wheaton. That woman is reportedly, according to authorities, his ex-girlfriend. She accuses him of stealing her debit card and jacket and SUV. He is also accused of threatening a police officer. Kennedy, who is from California, has appeared on MTV and in music videos with big names like Snoop Dogg.
Yeah, so, and then again, this dude is 36 years old, 3 + 6 = 9. The reporter hold the microphone saying 9. Destruction, all praises to the Most High. Yahweh, you can't make this hash up. All praises.
We are following a breaking news alert tonight. A man is under arrest after police say he broke into a home, but was then stabbed by the homeowner with a sword. Erica Francis is at the WKRN.com alert desk with new information. Erica?
Yeah, Bob, this is quite the story. According to our news content partners at Clarksville Now, the man is facing especially aggravated robbery charges. Clarksville police say 21-year-old Gustavio Russo has been arrested for the crime that happened on June 24th. Police.
So this guy's 21 years old. You know what to do.
They say the homeowner heard a loud crash and then his wife screaming. So he confronted Russo in the bedroom, and police say Russo hit the victim in the head with a blunt object. The homeowner fighting back with a walking cane that had a sword inside.
Damn.
Clarksville now said.
All praises to the Most High. Damn, that old man had a walking cane with a sword in it. Oh man, that is cool. Walking cane with a sword. Yes, all praises. Yes, the old man had a walking cane with a sword in it. Yes, sir, this old man had a walking cane and then got a freaking sword in there, man. And then stab you. You know, he thought they were a senior citizen, most likely. All right? This is cool. All praises, man. This walking cane has a sword in it. You know, this guy was just, you know, he thought, This is cool. This is beautiful.
As court documents show, there was another suspect in the house at the time. No word on if the other attacker has been arrested.
So again, this is plague number 5, destruction by the sword. And this guy, he didn't die. He lucky. All praises. Crazy thing. All right.
A night out on Washington Avenue turns violent. A bar brawl outside Bottled Blonde. Captured on video.
It is the latest example of an uptick in violence along the Washington Avenue corridor. Marcelino Benito spoke to neighbors frustrated who say it is only getting worse. Marcelino.
Len and Mia, a lot of these residents have lived here for nearly 2 decades, so they have seen a lot in their time here along Washington Avenue, but say this is as bad as it has ever been. And if nothing changes, they fear more people will get hurt, if not worse.
We're outside Bottled Blonde.
Oh my God.
Chaos erupted last Thursday night. Punches thrown, faces kicked, all while off-duty deputies body slammed brawlers to try and get the melee under control.
This is just another weekend on Washington Avenue.
Mark Fairchild is president of the Rice Military Civic Club. He says brawls like this are becoming far too common.
So those people, to them, they still haven't figured out what's going on, brothers. They still haven't figured out. In 400 years, they never seen anything like that. It's just now they all start seeing that this isn't normal. Why is this happening all the time? Why is it so frequent? Why is it for any little petty things, there's a brawl, there's some type of fighting going on? They still don't know that, well, they probably ignore the Heavenly Father's doing this.
Putting alcohol, other substances, testosterone and women in a pot and stirring it up and seeing what happens.
You guys been doing this. You guys been doing this for a while, but forever, for over 400 years. Then again, Washington Street, you know, 4800, you know what to do. 12 and 13 tribe, you know, Dinah, you know, the brothers and the sisters, okay, each on the side, you know, kicking Washington's ass. All praises to the Most High.
Happening is not good. Since COVID, several new bars have opened up along the corridor. That's meant more noise and, most troubling, increased gun violence.
At some point, you're having a shooting every weekend night.
And it's already turned deadly.
It's simply out of control.
Neighbors say the city allowed it to get this bad.
You've created 6th Street over here, a along Washington Avenue.
This brawl video now on Councilmember Abby Kamen's radar.
I am extremely disturbed and very frustrated, like many of the residents of our district, about what we saw.
She says HPD has increased patrols along the corridor through overtime initiatives, and a new loud noise unit is working the area too. But she admits more needs to be done.
It's a all hands on deck effort. That means that businesses are absolutely responsible and should be good community partners. Unfortunately, there's a few bars. I don't want to paint with broad strokes. There are a few bars that are bad actor bars.
Fairchild tells us he knows there are no easy answers, but at a minimum, they are in desperate need of more police.
There's more police work in the doors of the clubs than there are patrolling the streets of Washington Avenue.
Neighbors tell us they also want agencies like TABC to start taking a closer look at how these bars are operating. They say
that's not what that is. You people are under a curse, okay? There are demons in the midst of you. Well, there were always demons in the midst of you. Now they are turning against you. All right, all praises to the Most High.
And we're continuing to get new information on that breaking story from the Pentagon. Glad you're with us tonight here at 7 o'clock. I'm Adam Longo. There is certainly a lot to get to. We've got team coverage on the attack outside of the Pentagon today. The Associated Press is reporting that the suspect is dead and an officer was killed. The Pentagon Protection Force Agency confirmed that officer's death just within the past hour. Mike Valerio is near the scene right now with a step-by-step account of what happened, and our Jess Arnold is at George.
So let me see what happened. Pentagon attack suspect. Okay, some dude went over there and stabbed an officer. The officer shot him. He died. The officer died. So now you're seeing that for any little petty things, the angels are coming back and report onto us. The reason why I don't want to finish up the whole thing, because it's just happened this morning. And you know how those people are doing. They don't want you to see their failure, so they are hiding things and stuff. Okay, let us listen a little.
George Washington Hospital with more on the fallen officer. And here's a live look at the transit center near the scene. Now, the Pentagon Metro station is still shut down. WMATA says it will stay closed for the rest of the evening and reopen tomorrow morning. If any of this sounds familiar, it's because we had a similar situation at the Pentagon over a decade ago. We're going to look back on that moment in a few minutes. First, though, let's get to Mike Valerio.
So what they are trying to tell you, they're trying to tell the people like, hey, man, things like that happen all the time. Don't worry. I mean, we had an attack on the Capitol. Remember in 1812 when we had that attack? It happened. And then now we got this thing at the Pentagon. Hey, man, go to the highest court of the government. Give them a spirit of strife, division, resentment against one another. Those are the angels coming back and reporting onto us.
Yeah, who is close to the Pentagon? Mike, I understand we're getting some new information about the attack.
Well, that's right, Adam. Good evening to you. You know what we know through our partnership with CBS News, and according to two law enforcement officials who are directly familiar with this investigation, is that this is emerging as a fight between a Pentagon police officer and a suspect right here. Just after 10:30 this morning, the suspect here stabs that Pentagon officer in the bus bays behind us, unleashing this chaos right here, and there is a struggle for the officer's weapon at that point. We also know that responding law enforcement officers open fire and the officer's weapon also discharges. It's not clear, Adam, at this hour if the officer's weapon is what fatally wounds the suspect.
Whatever. So those people are dealing with a lot of hate right now. There are so much confusion. If you read the comment, so much confusion, okay? So now people are going to test the police when it comes to the Pentagon. This is a result of what happened already. So sorry for the officer's family, my condolences. As a retired officer, it truly breaks my heart to see these type of things keep playing out in this country, all of the negative energy directed to the good officer. The Pentagon is a military facility. Why is it not being secured by military personnel? A military facility? Is that what you think it is? You'd be surprised what the Pentagon is. I know the reporter didn't do it on purpose, but the suspect didn't lose his life. He gave it up. Confusion. All praises to the Most High.
Well, a woman in Montgomery.
This plague plague is the plague number 9, execution by the sword. All right.
The county is behind bars tonight after police say she admitted to killing her 92-year-old roommate. Julia Birch is being held without bond. Police say she called them yesterday morning and told them she killed renowned sculptor Nancy Frankel inside their Kensington home. When officers arrived, they found Frankel's body. An autopsy will determine her exact cause of.
So as you can see now, for any little, you know, thing, those people are killing each other. And for no reason, she murdered that woman and then she calls to say, I killed her. Till now, they don't know why. All praises to the Most High. Oops.
Video you'll only see on Local 10 News tonight of a belligerent passenger causing sheer chaos in the air. And it got so bad that flight attendants had to duct tape the man to his seat. Ever since masks were required on airplanes, flight attendants say that their work has become downright dangerous. Local 10 News reporter Bridget Matter is live now with our exclusive tonight. Bridget.
Calvin, we just learned from police that that unruly passenger was arrested and is facing 3 charges of battery. Things getting so out of hand, flight attendants pulling out tape to restrain him. Alfredo Rivera whipped out his cell phone after a man on his flight from Philly to Miami became unhinged.
I f***ing shot!
That's when he started to get aggressive and then basically attack the male flight attendants.
Then things got physical. Rivera captured the man being taped to a seat. Eventually, he began screaming for help. Miami-Dade police confirmed 22-year-old Maxwell Berry was arrested for 3 counts of battery. A police.
So now, beloved, ever since 2020 kicks in, you see there is an uptick, they like to call it that. There is an increase of this type of incident. Well, we know the ley lines run to the airport. We know the Heavenly Father tell those people, you are not under the blessing anymore. You guys will, for any little things, you will see those guys are fighting each other, beating and killing each other for no reason, for any reason whatsoever.
Police report says he groped the breasts of a female flight attendant that, quote, he came up from behind and put his arms around both of them and groped their breasts again. We emailed Frontier Airlines for comment on the situation.
Have you ever seen
always a Negro coming over there to the rescue? All right.
Someone get taped up like that in a plane?
No.
Yeah, this is actually funny, man. They had to tape up the guy and give them a spirit of madness, craziness, and foolishness. Yeah, all praises. Anyway, man, let us move to the next video.
A drone remains lodged in a building at the World Trade Center site after someone flew it in the area and it got stuck. According to sources, a 22-year-old man visiting from Texas had been flying the small device when it crashed into 7 World Trade. The man reported the incident himself and was taken into custody and issued a summons. Police do not believe there was any terror threat. The drone is said to be sitting between 2 glass panels.
Beloved, let me tell you something. The Most High God, the Most High Yahweh, the Most High Yah, the Most High Yahuwah, the Most High Haya, the Most High Noke said Adonai doesn't do anything by accident. The Heavenly Father never did anything because it is by coincidence. None of that. You see, today is August the 2nd, all right? And this happened, it hit 7 World, that's the name of the building, 7, which is perfection. A drone, a small drone hits 7 World Trade Center. A drone is another word, brothers, if we want to exaggerate, an airplane, okay, a little drone. It hit the 7 World Trade Center. And then the following day, the next day, a guy stabbed a police officer in the Pentagon. Now you see there's 2 attacks that happened in September 11, 2001. the Pentagon got attacked and the World Trade Center got attacked. And now you're seeing the same thing happen again. You see that the World Trade Center, quote unquote, got a drone hit it, stocks. And you see the Pentagon got two people die over there. It's no coincidence. It's the father signaling his children he about to do something very big. What come out of World Trade Center, brethren, is the economy. Okay, the economy and stuff like that. What's come out of Pentagon is the military. So the Mossad is about to hit both of them. The economy first, like the drone hit the World Trade Center. Is that thing even recording right now? Yes, it is. Is it? Sometime, man, it's 2, 1 a.m. Tired. Yeah, yes, it is. So the World Trade Center is the economy. So the Mossad is going to hit them. I don't know with what, but if it's a drone, it might be a flying chariot. We don't know. But it's going to hit them first there. And then the Pentagon is the seat where all the wars around the world, every single thing that happened to our people, that's where it being discussed in the Pentagon. You know, there's no reason the Pentagon is shaped like this, you know. Excuse me. Show me the Pentagon.
According to Wikipedia, the Pentagon.
Okay, the Pentagon is shaping like a star. Conspiracy theorist, man. Pentagram. Okay. All right. This is the Pentagon, you know, shaped like a pentagram. All right. You know, there you go. The pentagram. There we go. Baphomet and all that stuff. Those NASA, is it people kill yourself? Okay, all right. So the Pentagon and all that, 666, Mark of the Beast, all that crap and stuff. But anyway, so all right, there you go. So the Pentagon is shaped like this. You know, that's where all the wars, all the things, and. Beloved, our prayers are working so fast. We just had a prayer today calling the angels to foil their plan. Excuse me. To sabotage their plan. The prayer was called
Heavenly Father.
The prayer name is Sabotage Upon Their Evil Plans. You don't know what kind of evil plan that they have over there in the Pentagon for our people. You don't know when that police officer and that fellow that died over there, you don't know what kind of spirit they scared away. You don't know what kind of spirit that ran away that was supposed to be there to strengthen one of their spirits, one of their plan. And they got deconcentrated. They got unfocused. And then they have to run and leave whatever they were doing to go see what's happening out there. And now their plan is not working. You never know, brothers. Yesterday, while they were performing that witchcraft inside of that Pentagon, that ritual, they had this specific moon over there, that specific stars that only come every 400 years. And they had that one shot of doing this thing without being interrupted. And then the Mossad got a 2/3 or whatever, one scumbag stabbed the officer shot him. And they're like, there's an attack outside the Pentagon. And then they get startled and then the moon pass or the star pass and they have to wait another 400 years. You don't know what those people were doing in there, but the Mossad spoiled it. The Mossad foiled it. Sabotage upon their evil plans. All praises to the Most High. You can't make this up. All right? You can't make that up. So now you see the World Trade Center got hit. The Pentagram got hit. You're going to see that the economy is going to get hit really hard they ain't gonna be able to start it at all. And the Pentagon, where they have all those people discussing war, how they're going to invade this country, how they're going to go to that country, how they're going to manipulate and bring. The Pentagon is where the CIA and all the FBI connection, all the scumbag stuff, that where they at. So those people are the one that always come in there and then planning things and all their evil projects. They always have it there, and then so they can put it upon the loin of the children of the Most High. Now look what happened to them. Look what happened, beloved brothers, when that thing hit 7 in World Trades. You don't know what kind of thing those people were doing in there. And once they hit, like, hey, a drone hit the building, you know the flashback those people will get. That will that will unfocus your ass if you are concentrating on something. And then we'll have flashback like 9-11, you know, a little small airplane just hit the train. You know, it is so serious that they had to arrest the guy. And he didn't do anything. They had to arrest it. He could have not even reported, but he reported. They arrested him, then probably give him a citation or something. And then they let him go. Oh, praise the Most High. Boy, my prayer is going to begin at 2 a.m. It's 1:30 now. Let us keep on moving, brethren.
James says all she right. was surrounded by the motorcyclist. And
watch this. Watch this.
But we begin with a scary scene on a crowded Chicago expressway. A motorcycle crash ends in flames. Brazen, risky, illegal. Just 3 words to describe what you're about to see. New at 10, our Charlie DeMar spoke with a woman trapped in the middle of the mess.
These stunts aren't being performed on closed roads or a professional course. This is the Stevenson Saturday afternoon. This rider pops a wheelie, touches his feet together in midair. Moments later, he loses control while trying to touch the ground. Another rider violently flips over the crashed bike, causing a fiery pileup. Other riders stop to help, even seen patting the fire out on one of the injured drivers.
Great job, everyone.
So that's what happened. Those people think they can do the same scumbag and enjoy the blessing again. They can't. They can't. The ley line switch. This guy fell, you know, all praises to the Most High.
Rebecca James was driving right behind the crash.
It was a swarm, to say the least. There was a fireball, just a complete fireball.
James says she was surrounded by the motorcyclist and ATVs. Some started banging on her window after the wreck, and with seemingly nowhere to go because of the crash, she started recording on her cell phone.
My life was in danger. There's no doubt about it. There's a sense of like, what are you doing in our space? Get off.
The riders involved in the crash identified themselves in a social media post. They're both okay, saying they accept the risk that goes along with stunt rides and don't blame anyone.
They don't like how I talk to them.
The motorcycle meetup attracted hundreds, some from out of state. They rode throughout the city all weekend. A YouTube video shows those dangerous stunts up close. Other video posted online from the loop shows hundreds of motorcycles passing through, even using the sidewalk to get around.
How many people's lives were put into danger? Well, it's profoundly selfish. That's the thing that is frustrating.
Yeah, so the Most High is giving them no peace. So all praise is the Most High, man, you know. Now, I love this video. You know, for a while we've been monitoring this. Watch this, brothers. Those are dolphins. Look at this. Look at this. At least 50 of them here, man. Look at this. Look at this, brothers. Look, this is beautiful. Look at this. All right, let's watch it in slow motion. Okay, mega part of common dolphin visit Oceanside. Okay, so they never seen that before, but wow, you know, the Most High having the animal doing this, man. Okay, all right. Okay, look at this. Look at this. A bunch of dolphins, man. They look like killer whale. Well, they call them common dolphins, so they're all over swimming. Fast, not quite sure why, but hopefully the Most High is sending us a good message here. Look at this. It's like a lot of them. And those things are very fast. Wow. See? Wow. Got at least 50 of them, man. Megapod. Look at this. All right. All praises to the Most High, man. This is beautiful. We see this a lot with whales and dolphin and all that stuff. Okay. All right. We give praises to the Most High. Crazy thing. Crazy thing. All praises.
This is breaking news.
Over 60 firefighters are on the scene of a roof collapse in Brooklyn. This is Lincoln Road near the intersection of New York Avenue. Part of a roof collapsed down. We can see firefighters trying to work on that building to get to at least where we're getting reports of at least one worker that's trapped in this incident. So the firefighters, again, over 60 of them on the scene trying to make efforts to get to that worker.
Yeah, so you're now seeing like a lot of people again. A lot of people are getting crushed under collapsing roof. Okay, so let's read it. And they have the nerve to charge ridiculous rent. That's what happened when you remove too many supports. I always thought the balcony raised the roof. What a tragedy. Put a bicycle lane and therefore building during the inspection. New York City falling apart every day. Dang, everything is collapsing in New York. Just stopped by my store. America march towards third world status continues. Yeah. And after that pancakes, another one right there. All praises to the Most High. All praises. Oh, well, we watched this. Beautiful. The lightning strike, the trees split it in half. All praises. We watched this before.
Kind of,
Okay, so... Woman being stuck by a coyote gets rescued by boulder. Okay, this is plague number 7. Wild beasts will be their graves, okay?
A woman taking a leisurely stroll on a beautiful beach suddenly finds herself being stalked by a coyote. It's the last place in the world you'd imagine something like this happening. Every moment of the terrifying experience was recorded by two guys on a boat just offshore.
There's a lady getting attacked by a coyote out here.
The coyote seemed kind of content that he had cornered me, just kept coming at me. And I'm screaming at that point.
Mercy Sterlis was vacationing on Cape Cod. Yes, that Cape Cod in Massachusetts, one of America's most famous beach destinations.
I was like saying, get out of here, go on, get out of here. It wasn't responding. It just kept coming back at me. I was terrified.
So give them a spirit of fear. Usually, Bridget, things like that won't happen. A freaking coyote will be definitely afraid of this woman. That's, she was getting a vacation. He enjoyed the beach and all that. Oh, hell no. Not with the Most High, man. Oh, hell no. You ain't gonna come over here and enjoy the blessing like this. Send a freaking coyote after you. As you can see, beloved, we see a lot of incidents starting with coyotes. For those of you who've been watching, we see a lot of sighting, and then you got this. In the previous video that we released, we saw a coyote and stuff like that, you know. Hey, all praise.
And get this, during her 10-minute-long ordeal, her boyfriend called her to see how she was enjoying her walk on the beach. Wow, was he surprised.
I was like, I need you to look up online what to do about a coyote.
The guys in the boat pulled up as close to the beach as they could. She waited to them and was pulled on board.
It's great to see her faces again.
You can't make this a shot, man. You can't make that up. You cannot make this up, okay? The Most High always put something in there. Say, I'm tormenting those people right here. This dude right there. You know, all of them, all three of them are the same. You know, if you look in this guy's neck, you know, he has the mark of the beast, the cross, the crucifix, which you've been seeing practically in all our videos. You see it. You see those people always the one that are into some bull. And that's the Most High. All praises to the Most High, man. All right, this Christian lady, Christian man, and Christian this and that. That's what happened. The Most High is tormenting them.
I am so thankful for your help. It was a very dire situation. I am extremely grateful for you coming to my rescue. Thank you.
Not a problem. We're just happy that you're okay.
Experts say you should never turn your back on a coyote and run. Also, don't let coyotes intimidate you. Threaten them with loud noises.
Everything you hear about what you're supposed to do when you encounter a wild animal, I was doing. Like, I had run out of options. I don't want to get bit by a coyote.
All praises to the Most High, man. A lot of coyote attacks, man.
It's too much. It's only so much a person can take, and this is too much. This is too much.
There's an old saying, lightning doesn't strike twice. But Tiffany Marshall and her son Anthony will tell you otherwise. On July 9th, a Jeep crashed into their home, destroying everything in their front room.
Okay, July 9th. Destruction. July 9th, a Jeep crashed their house. Listen, nine, destruction, okay.
Boom, like a big jerk, and everything jerked. Stuff flew, screws went through the wall, went through the staircase. I'm like, wow.
Exactly 3 weeks later, on July 30th, another Jeep, another crash. Both times, the vehicles breaking through the floor into the basement.
What are the coincidences? This woman right there, she doesn't, I'm assuming she doesn't know that this is a Jeep and another Jeep. You see, this is not something that happened by chance. That means this woman house is on top of a powerful ley line. You don't have this happen two times in 1 month, both cars being Jeep. This just doesn't happen. Well, she doesn't have the knowledge of the, you know, the ley line. But anyway, all praises to the Most High. Let us continue.
Bent.
And my son was just getting ready to come down. And that's when I heard it go boom. I said, not again.
They've lived here at Shoemaker and McClellan on Detroit's east side since 2006. Just off of Gratiot, Tiffany says drivers speed through here all the time, crashing into her front lawn twice. And now this, two times in 1 month.
The first time where my mom or me or my grandma could have been in there and we could have died from that.
It's just depressing. It's stressful. Just the thing. How many times this gonna happen? Is it gonna happen again?
And I keep having nightmares and everything, and I can't do.
Okay, so that's the woo, that's the Most High confirming, you know, it's transformed their dream into nightmare. Well, those people, quote unquote, seems to look like us. Not all skin folks or kinfolks. They could be Gentiles. Definitely, they could be two-thirds, and the Most High is terrorizing them. Okay, so this is not normal. Okay, two Jeeps below.
Nightmares and everything, and I can't do anything about it.
Like it's the devil just hanging over here. Like go.
Nah, that's just confirming. She's a sister, most likely a two-third. She's a sister, all right? Only our people talk like this. I guess the devil hang out over there.
Like
don't say.
The devil just hanging over here. Like, go that way, because we're done. We had enough.
That's now not the drive. It's not going to happen. You know, those are two-third. It is confirmed. Those are people, but they are two-third. But it just doesn't happen like this. The Most High is tormenting you. Most likely those people, they know somebody in the truth. They've been telling them, they rebuke the person, and the Most High send them this strong confirmation, but they really don't want to listen. So, you know, and then they realize now, they won't say God do this. They say, oh, the devil do it. That's how you know they are Christian, because God is too good. They won't hurt them. God won't hurt them. But the Heavenly Father did this, okay?
Drivers in both crashes, they were injured. They were taken to area hospitals, but they did survive. Meanwhile, we will be putting a link to Tiffany and Anthony's GoFundMe page on our website, fox2detroit.com.
Okay, all praises to the Most High, all right? So this happened August 1st, so weird, all praises.
of these mudslides. CDOT leaders said this afternoon that there were at least 10 mudslides through Glenwood Canyon.
108 people got stuck on the highway as a result.
108 people got stuck in a highway, okay, as a result of what?
Result of flash flooding and mudslides last week. Authorities say some people waited it out in their cars, others got a little creative.
Yeah, one man jumped into a CDOT forklift and started clearing the debris himself until the check engine light came on. Good evening, and thanks for joining us for Denver 7 News at 5.
So, you see the mudslides is destroying those people. It's not giving them peace. And those people don't know what to do. Everything, a mudslide came in, you know, at least 10 to 12 feet deep, covered the place. They can't go anywhere to Highway I-70. Again, 108 people, 1 plus 0 plus 8 equal destruction, I-70. The mudslide is hitting those people on all sides, and they cannot handle this.
Railroad tracks into... Well, it's a very devastating night.
We had this again.
Ocean Beach just hours beforehand.
Hey, just go.
I am an OB love.
This is 51-year-old Michael Sewell in Ocean Beach on Monday morning. Just a couple hours before he ended up in downtown San Diego in a standoff with police. Officers say he wouldn't come out of his car after evading arrest, so they fired pepper balls into the vehicle, and that's when Sewell took off. News 8.
Now, you see how they all handle this guy, this demon? Look at the guy. Look at the guy's face. This is a demon right there. They are handling this guy with a kid glove. They are shooting pellets at him. They don't want to do anything. And then a lot of that stuff. This cop already standing there with his taser. A taser behind him. All right. They got pellet gun, you know, fake bullets. And let me see, there's a cop that showed it. He had some type of thing.
Onto a sidewalk and clipping a News 8 vehicle Monday afternoon is now behind bars facing felony charges.
News 8's David Gofferson has been tracing the man's moves that day and found people who say the man got into an argument in Ocean Beach just hours beforehand.
If there was one of the people that look like us, this guy name is JC Pagan. What a blasphemy, man. JC Pagan. JC was a father of David anyway, so you can't make this up, but whatever, man. So, you know, and if it was one of ours, they would have raided the car with bullets. But yet the cop just standing there, they didn't do anything.
Just go.
I am an OB love.
This is 51-year-old Michael Sewell in Ocean Beach on Monday morning.
Again, I just realized this guy name is Michael, and we know the Archangel Michael is beloved. How many people that we find their name are Michael? Literally every video that we make, somebody name is Michael. You know, Michael is standing for the people, man, and he's showing you that he's destroying those people. All praises to the Most High.
Is just that a couple calling? Hours before he ended up in downtown San Diego.
Okay, they had taser. Usually those guys would pull out their gun and stuff and start shooting the brother that was in the car, but hey, you know, that's
in a standoff with police. Officers say he wouldn't come out of his car after evading arrest.
So they would have dragged this guy and pull him out. Look at this, fingers not on the trigger. Look at how this guy, this cop holding this gun. His hand is not even on a trigger. He just hold it. Look at this.
So they fired pepper balls into the vehicle, and that's when Sewell
look at this. Okay, they are firing pepper paint to try to scare this guy. They didn't break the window. Come on, get on the ground. And that guy run, and then they just standing there watching. Look at them. Look at the cops. They didn't do anything.
News 8 photojournalist Bruce Patch was right there. He caught it all on videotape.
And next thing I know, he's coming down the sidewalk, and I grabbed my camera and went backwards like this, and he ended up plowing right through here, right past us, and people just scattered.
The driver took out the rear bumper of the News 8 vehicle, and nearly took out people on the sidewalk as well.
I'll tell you what, the people who were standing right here, if they didn't move quicker, they'd be dead.
It's all right.
Earlier that morning, Sewell got into a scuffle in Ocean Beach, according to witnesses, who say his pit bull attacked a smaller dog.
And he pushed the owner of the small dog, and that person fell down. And then another person came and tackled him for pushing that person down. And I joined in to restrain the guy because he was definitely becoming aggressive.
Navy,
let them do this. Don't get involved. Let them get involved with themselves. When you see Gentiles going at each other's throat, stay out of it.
Veteran Clint Kent recorded this video after the scuffle was over.
I didn't attack nobody. I was trying to get my dog.
Kent says police were called, but officers did not arrive in time.
You know, when he sped off and almost hit a gentleman with a giant longboard crossing the street, you know, then we knew it was, you know, he needed to be stopped.
Sewell is now behind bars facing felony charges of evading arrest and assault with a deadly weapon, as well as misdemeanor counts of hit and run and resisting arrest.
They didn't do anything to this guy. All praises to the Most High. Give them a spirit
burglary
of madness.
Here, thieves scoping out targets while riding little girls' bikes. Local firefighter suddenly became a victim.
Local 10's Andrew Perez is live in Davie with the exclusive. Andrew.
And, you know, these guys didn't care who they were hurting. They barely cared that there were cameras pretty much all over this neighborhood. They did more damage than they probably realize.
Those people were coming in to steal whatever they could find.
And what they found besides a car was Zandy Triana's firefighter gear. A member of the Palm Beach County Fire Rescue Team, he says the crooks dealt a big blow when they took the car and everything in it.
On what they call a floater. So you keep your gear with you because you're at a different station filling in depending where you're going. So my firefighter gear was in there, my personal tools, and my dress shirts with my badge and my name tag.
Cameras catch the guy on a pink kiddie bike. He checks to see if this car is locked. It is, so he moves on. He moves to Triana's house, where an accomplice is already working. They find car keys tucked away inside of a different car and ride off. Well, it turns out they were ditching the bikes they were using because seconds later, they come back, but they're on foot and they're running. Both go straight for the car and leave.
For somebody to just come and take it like this. And it's sad, you know?
On top of it, there's the peace of mind that gets taken away from you, right? Some days I'm at work for 24 hours. She's home alone. Now I'm concerned at work and she's scared at home.
That's the Most High. Give them a spirit of fear, you know? Send the god dang two-third in there, you know? Give them nothing. But trouble. And it has come to my attention now, beloved, that I'm starting to make connection that she has this shirt, the dolphin, and we just see the video of the dolphin pad. You know, probably the dolphin are bringing us joy, but they are bringing them fear. Most likely that's what that is. We don't know. All praises to the Most High, okay?
And get this, police were seen driving through just minutes after this happened. Southwest 136th Avenue and 9th Place in Davie. The gear is still missing, along with the four-door gray Honda Civic, a firefighter sticker on the back window. The couple and their neighbors hoping these guys are caught.
They tried getting into my car, and they stole his car. No, there's no respect for others, no respect for other people's property.
Yeah, that's what that is, man.
Yeah, it's unfortunate.
So things like that used to happen in the hood. So now you got the, you know, it happened to them. Now the hood is on the suburb. All praises to the Most High.
This is the first time we're attending a birth like this. The most important delivery we've seen was four babies that I've seen in my career. But the births of these babies, nine babies, it's very rare. She's the first one to give birth to nine babies who are alive and healthy.
Such pregnancies are extremely dangerous for the mother, but this clinic was determined to keep both mom and...
So that's the woman that gave birth to... No, this is her and her husband, the Mali woman. She's 26. She gave birth to nine little babies. You know, that says something right there. Say, hey, call them a gift from Yahweh. All praises. It is good to give the Most High praises like this, okay? All praises. Let us go.
Have described as a troubling relationship between the two.
And Fox 9's Mary McGuire joining us with more on this story. Mary?
Well, there is some really gruesome video of this crime circulating on social media, which Fox 9 is choosing not to show. Friends and co-workers who came to the vigil tonight say they want America to be remembered as the sweet and kind person that she was, not for the tragic way that she died.
gone but never forgotten.
Holding a sign and balloons, Faith Howie and her family came to the intersection of 4th Avenue and Spencer Street to honor the life of their neighbor, America Thayer.
I'm not going to see that beautiful smile again that I've seen every day.
They weren't alone. Former coworkers and friends stopped by the memorial, leaving flowers to remember a woman they call an angel on earth.
I'm still kind of...
Again, they always, put Cesar Boja here. And, you know, those are signs the Most High put here. You know, this woman got beheaded, you know.
On earth.
I'm still kind of in shock.
It's just really hard and very traumatizing.
Just one day earlier, Shakopee police were called to that intersection. A search warrant reveals when they arrived, they found Thayer's decapitated body lying on the ground next to a car. Authorities say they have a suspect in custody, who multiple people tell Fox 9 was in a long-term relationship with Thayer, where domestic abuse was a consistent problem. About a month ago, Howie says Thayer came to her apartment looking for help.
She goes, can I come sleep here tonight? She goes, I'm afraid he's going to get up and start in again.
Court records reveal the suspect was convicted on domestic assault charges in 2017 and was facing arson charges for allegedly trying to burn his apartment down.
So, and in a guy like this, you should have run for your life, but she's still with him. And then that thing happened in Spencer Street. You know, they always tell us we are the people that do. They always call us animal. And Spencer turned out to be Spencer Planet of the Ape. Spencer Planet of the Ape. Okay, so Spencer. You know, Spencer turned out to be a monkey, a savage. That's what they used to call us. Is that Spencer right here? Is that his name? I think that's the 1968 version, you know, Planet of the Eight. Yeah, so I guess that's that thing happened in Spencer. I guess the Most High is returning them back to their, you know, to their original form, you know. So, yeah, all praises, man.
On the most recent charges, he was released on $50,000 bond this spring. Those close to Thayer say they don't want people to remember the way she died, but rather the way she lived.
We just needed a time for everyone to heal and come together and just remember for who she was and not for what happened.
Now, on Wednesday afternoon, the suspect was scheduled to be in court, but he didn't show up. Formal charges are expected to be filed.
Wow, that's the Most High releasing demon out there, man. Take her out of. All praises to the Most High. All praises.
To breaking news alert.
And that breaking news alert, U.S. Marshals arrest a teen for murder along with his mother. The 16-year-old Mondrell Newsom and his mom, 41-year-old Sharon Newsom.
The dude is 16. The mailbox is 331. Equals 7. 16, 1 plus 6 equals 7. They got him and the mother. Perfection.
Mondrell Newsom and his mom, 41-year-old Sharon Newsom, were wanted in the death of Gerald Leroy Jr. in June. These two were arrested in Louisville, Kentucky just today. Newsom is believed to be the person in that picture there fleeing the scene. His mother has outstanding warrants in Nashville for felony aggravated assault and probation violation. You can always track news as it breaks on...
Yeah, those are the demons, man. The Most High is bringing them out, taking others out.
I'm Josh Breslow with the WKRN.com Alert Desk. Disturbing new details this morning out of Memphis. An 83-year-old woman discovered by a home health care worker inside her apartment without any clothes, lying in her own filth. Police say Foster's grandchildren, seen right here, were supposed to be caring for her at the time. Investigators tell our sister station they were instead neglecting her and spraying her with air freshener to hide that smell. The woman was transported to a hospital, we're told, with multiple injuries that included infected bones. It also appeared she had been left without food or water for up to 10 days. Again, that information from investigators. All three grandchildren are now charged with aggravated neglect. We're going to follow this story and post all the details on our website. Head to WK.
So those are what happened when into those Christian, okay? They spent their entire life, and this is what they produce. Three grandchildren that neglected them like this. So that must have been a horrible ordeal for that person. 10 days with no food, no water, and your own filth wallowing in there. You know, and that's what happened. That's what happened to those Christians. They are catching hell, and then they are calling the nation, hey, pray for me. My three grandchildren did this for me. And then when you ask them about that church thing, they're like, I can't do this. I can't. Hey, that's what happened, man. Horrible thing, but hey, we give praises to the Most High.
Apparently, there was a dispute over masks, so they didn't get very far. A ruckus inside Fort Lauderdale Hollywood International Airport. And a takedown that all started with a dispute over mask wearing. That seems to be a sign of the times. It happened last Friday. We're told airline staff asked this party of five from New Jersey and on board a Spirit flight to leave the plane because...
Wow. Wow, wow, wow. You know, always like, you know, Cesar Borgia masquerading himself as Archangel Michael in the mist. You know, so it's always something with those guys, man. But anyway, all praises.
To leave the plane because they would not comply with mask rules. When they arrived to the gate, the Broward Sheriff's Office says deputies tried to de-escalate the situation, but according to the probable cause affidavit, they started yelling profanities. One of the men, Drake Lloyd, pushed a deputy. His dad, identified as William Lloyd, reportedly pushed another deputy to get to his sons. In the end, those two now face charges of battery on a law enforcement officer, all five charged with disorderly conduct. And if you think these disruptions are on the rise, they are.
You care about yourself. You are...
This was an incident last week involving a maskless man on a flight to Miami. The Federal Aviation Administration reporting more than 2,600 unruly passenger incidents that are mask-related this year alone. And so...
It's going up, you know, and then you're going to see much more gruesome thing going to happen. Don't be surprised if somebody start popping popcorn in there.
I know at this point I'm tired of crying. I am. Last night I cried myself to sleep.
Coco McCoy, in her Locust Grove home, along with her husband Antonio, just found out what they had feared all along. Police confirmed that the remains found in these woods in Henry County were those of her missing 19-year-old daughter, Kantisha McCoy. Kantisha's remains found next to the remains of 23-year-old Mercia Victor. Victor was murdered earlier this month, police say, by a 41-year-old man named Dennis Lane, a convicted sex offender who lives nearby these woods. Coco McCoy says Lane is the same man who had been stalking her daughter, Kantisha, claiming he wanted to marry her just before she disappeared this past February. But in the past 5 months, leading up to Mercia Victor's death, Locust Grove police, she says, never pursued the leads she gave them that Lane might be responsible for her daughter's disappearance.
And I hate it for the Victor family. They had to endure that. You know, all this could have been avoided if you would have just went to his house like we kept telling you to do. If you just would have went, you couldn't save my daughter, but you could have saved somebody else's child.
We will work to reach Locust Grove police for comment. Kantisha, she says, was funny, always sending her videos to make her laugh, took good care of her younger siblings. Now she knows she is gone, but can't believe it.
I just thought she was going to walk through that door and I'll never see my baby again.
All praises to the Most High, man. The Most High is bringing hell to a lot of people out there. They don't want to come in. And that's what happened, you know, that's what happened. We give the Most High praises and glory. Let us close with this.
All right, check this out. It could have ended much worse. A contractor working on a construction site in Salem smelled something burning nearby and heard a woman yelling for help. Brian Butte tells us that he then ran down the alley and saw flames on the deck of an apartment building. He was able to grab a garden hose and start spraying water on that fire. Then, about 10 minutes later, someone brought him a fire extinguisher and he finished putting out the flames. Thank you to a viewer named Jerry for letting us know about this good deed. Remember, if you see something out there that is happening, you can...
Now, you see how the Mossad is tormenting those people. This is a fiery conflagration. Okay, the apartment caught on fire. There are so many things and so much are happening out there, beloved brothers and sisters. We really don't have the time to cover all of this, okay? Deadly car bombing in Kabul, Afghanistan. You know, 91-year-old man found dead in the Bronx. Trenton native Moore. Oh, okay, that's all the crap. Yeah, there are so many things, okay? Oklahoma family calling for more answer after teen daughter's death or suicide. So, yeah, you know, and the Mossad is visiting the earth. A lot of things are going on. And we give the Mossad praises and glory for everything. Beloved brothers and sisters, it was a pleasure for me being here with you. I leave you with peace. Be at peace, brothers. Fast, pray, repent, repeat. May the King reign forever.